it's better to bend, not break. But, I mean, we don't like to bend too much. And it, I mean, it was definitely a lot of yards out there. But I feel like a lot of guys went out there, and we got our hands on a couple balls. A couple balls, guys made plays. Those guys on scholarship as well. And, you know, we just wanted to go out there and keep them out of the end zone. And I think for the most part, we did an all right job. But we can still get better.
What can you do to tighten up the passing yards, allowing
that? Just focusing in, man. Because, I mean, when you get a team to stop the run like that, it's kind of hard to just always focus on just the pass and stuff like that. So, I mean, it's kind of give take, but we're going to find a happy balance.
OJ, your pick in the red zone late when it's 31-16 and they're threatening. Did you confuse Bortles with that? Did you have more people in coverage he expected, or did he just have to kind of force that at that point?
I really don't know. I don't know what his reads were. I don't really know what his reads were exactly at that time. But, you know, it was just guys out there really just making sure that we didn't want to get them out of the end zone. If we had a chance to make a play, we wanted to make it.
Was that the call then? You didn't blitz or anything that I remember seeing. So you guys were just in straight coverage.
Yeah.
Okay. Just one of those things where it ends up going right to you.
Hey, man, good guys.
It looked like his eyes were kind of really locked in on McGuffey there. Did you see read that?
I kind of played his eyes a little bit, but I can't really honestly tell you like right now like exactly what it was. But, I mean, you know, I read his eyes, and I kind of just trusted myself.
Can you just talk about the importance of that play, man? Pretty much sealed it for you, right?
Man, I mean, I don't really know if that was the play to seal it but or anything like that, but I know it was in the red zone, and definitely when we get turnovers in the red zone, that's stuff we look for because we don't like to be down there too much.
About what percentage of the time were you guys in nickel today?
I can't even tell you the percent exactly, but I know it was a couple of times because they came out in a lot of 11 personnel just with a lot of wide receivers, so we ran a lot more nickel.
Did they surprise you with that? Because the scouting report coming in on them was that they'd be more of a power offense.
Yeah, but, I mean, we pride ourselves on defense on not letting them run the ball. So, I mean, we wanted to go out there and try to make them one-dimensional as possible. So, I mean, they had to eventually go to it. But.
Did you hear Urban Meyer say that he was personally involved in getting you more playing time this week?
I heard about it and everything like that, but I definitely appreciated it.
How did you hear about it?
They had told me over there at the Woody.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Oren, you guys trying to lead the country in interceptions this year?
Yes, sir. Definitely, man. You know, Travis setting the tone, so we're just trying to follow in his footsteps right now.
Yeah, you might be leading right now. I don't know. Three a game.
You know, Travis got two last game. He got one this game, so he might be slowing down. So I might have a chance to catch up with him. Definitely.
Thank you, sir.
No problem.
Oren, you're a high school quarterback.
Yes, man.
How much does that help you these days?
I mean, it helps a lot. It helps a lot more, like, at the safety spot. But, I mean, kind of like at the nickel, just understanding where you know that tackles can lie and guards can't. So, you know, I could get kind of like a little heads on the run read sometimes. And then just alignments, you know, certain splits and stuff like that, I kind of know, like, okay, well, then you can work a slant this way. You can work a post this way. I mean, it helps like that a little bit on certain things.
Coach Meyer says he wants more pressure on opposing quarterbacks. Mm-hmm. I'm assuming your view of what's going on is better than mine from the press box. What are you seeing going on?
I mean, I couldn't have got a better group of D-line that we have right now. Those guys are hungry. Those are motor. They got a lot of motors out there, and they got a great leaders in that group. And, I mean, those guys get a lot of pressure. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Johnny had kind of got a little banged up or whatnot. But, I mean, with Johnny, Hank, Nate Williams, you know, young guys like Noah Spence and Adolphus coming in, I mean, it's going to get real rough for somebody to have to single out and single block one of those guys.